What is going on, everybody? Today is a real pleasure. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for being here. I hope that you guys are ready to learn about some Facebook ads. Okay, cool. So let's talk about Facebook campaigns objectives. So Facebook campaign objectives. When you're creating an advertising campaign on Facebook, what happens is that you need to choose and pick a Facebook campaign objective. And guess what? A lot of people are not getting the results that they want to get because they choose the wrong campaign objective. And it really matters what type of campaign objective you're using, because Facebook has a lot of data out of its, you know, users. So what will Facebook do is to place people in different buckets. So if you choose the traffic campaign objective, you will get a lot of clickers. You will get people that like to click on things and they'd like to visit pages. If you choose the conversion campaign objective, you will be targeting people that like to convert. They like to go in and opt in for stuff, or maybe they even like to buy stuff out of Facebook, of all places. And number three, if you choose something like engagement, you will get a lot of engagers. You will get people that like to engage with comments, likes, shares, comments, likes, and all of that. So what happens is that a lot of people are not getting the results that they want because they're choosing the wrong campaign objective. And then they, you know, they jump on a call with me, they consult with me, or they, you know, jump on the various groups that I have, like the No BS Advertising Club, and they come and we crack open their ad account and they just chosen the wrong campaign objective. That's why they're not getting the results. So let me show you guys my top three campaigns objectives that I'm running right now so that it can simplify your Facebook ads buying, if you were, okay? So the first campaign objective that I always run, it doesn't matter what type of, you know, objective I have, or what type of funnel, or what type of product I'm trying to promote on Facebook, I always, always run a conversion campaign. So number one is conversion. The reason why is because, again, I'm a direct response guy, right? I'm an advertiser guy, I'm an ad guy, and I'm a direct response guy. So what I like to do with people when I'm running my ads is to get them to respond to an offer. And the offer could be a free PDF or a webinar or a consultation or whatever it is that you're promoting. It can be buy my new e-commerce product. It can be, you know, sign up for a free 30-minute presentation. But on any of those cases, you want to run the conversion campaign. Conversion campaign objective will be showing your ads to people that are prone to convert. And not only that, a lot of people are complaining that if you run like something like, I don't know, engagement versus conversions, you will end up paying more per impression here. These are more expensive ads. And it makes sense, right? Because Facebook needs to do a lot of math and it needs to do a lot of deep learning, provided that you have your pixel installed in your funnel, to actually get you the results that you're looking for. So they're charging you a premium. But that premium is completely 100% on point because they're giving you converters. And the more you run the ads, the more converters you will get. So the pixels become smarter. And guess what? Your ads will start performing better. I always say that advertising gets better through time. The more you advertise, specifically when you're running conversion campaigns, the better your results will be. The second top three campaign objective that I'm using these days is this one, video views. If you guys have been following me for a while, you know that I'm big into building audiences and show them ads, right? In fact, I just posted on my timeline, there's two things that you're doing when you're advertising. You're building audiences and you're showing ads and you're showing offers to those audiences. That's all there is to it. So I'm a big believer in video views, or you can also use engagement as an additional, you know, as a backup objective, if you would. And the reason why is because if you have valuable content, if you have really valuable videos, you want to start building audiences. Video views are still super cheap on Facebook. Well, I was talking about how video views are super cheap and you can build a big, large audience for pennies at this point, okay? So I think I spent like $2,000 to build like a $15,000 audience on Facebook. Entrepreneurs, business owners, people that like advertising, okay? In the US, Canada, UK, and Australia. So that is a small investment compared if you wanted to get them in your list. If you're paying like $2 to $3 per lead, that's like a $30,000 or $40,000 investment, right? Versus $2,000. So what's happening is that right now, video views are still really, really viable for you to actually go ahead and build audiences. And number three, which is going to be a surprise to many of you guys, is this one, traffic. What do you mean with traffic, Hernan? Well, you know, I just told you guys that, you know, if you're choosing the wrong campaign objective, if you're choosing, like, for instance, a traffic objective, you will get a lot of clickers, right? You will get a lot of traffic to your page, but that doesn't necessarily mean that they convert, right? But here's the good news, is that you can combine these objectives right here, including the traffic one. You can combine them. You can combine traffic with conversions, with video views and whatnot. And the only reason why I would use a traffic campaign is when I'm retargeting people. Okay, when I'm retargeting somebody that watched my webinar but didn't buy, or when I'm retargeting somebody that landed on my thank you page or landed on my order page but they didn't buy. That's how I'm retargeting people, with traffic and also with conversions. But here's the thing. When you're running conversion ads, I told you guys that Facebook uses, you know, its algorithm, its math, and uses all of this good stuff to actually understand and show your ads to people that are prone to convert, right? If somebody gets shown your ad because they are in the conversion bucket, right? And they get shown your ad, and they click on the ad, they go through the entire process, they go through the webinar, they watch the webinar, they land on your order form, right? They just need a little push at that point to buy. So the best thing to do at that point is not to run a conversion campaign, but to run a traffic campaign and show them more ads to these people, because you want to get them back into the order form. You want to get them back into the order form, and maybe they will make up their mind, and maybe they won't buy from you, maybe they would. So these traffic campaigns are super profitable if applied correctly. Again, the only reason why I use traffic campaigns is because I want people that went really deep into my funnel to go back to the place that they left, which could be the order form, or it could be a thank you page, or whatever that is. So this is basically what I'm doing. Now, again, you can combine them. You can combine conversions campaigns with video views. If you're building an audience, you can then show them conversion ads. If you have a funnel, you can actually show them traffic to people that went really deep into your funnel. And the video views campaigns will keep on building your audiences, which is basically what you're doing. You're building audiences and you're targeting them with offers. So these are my top three campaigns that I'm running right now, campaign objectives. Go ahead and give them a go. I hope that you go ahead and use them because they're really, really powerful. Again, if you want more techniques like this that have to do with advertising, but also funnel building, offer building, and all of that, go to hernanvasquez.com/book, get a brand new copy of my brand new book, Perpetual Profits. It's a PDF. You don't have to wait for the mailman, which is email it to you through the interwebs, and you will have it right away. And you can read it in the afternoon. And a lot of people are checking it out. A lot of people are loving it. Go check out all of the good things that people are saying on that page. Thank you guys for joining me. If you have any questions, feel free to join me actually on my Q&A show. It's marketingatlasshow.com. If you go there, you can actually watch last week's replay. But if you go there, marketingatlasshow.com, you can drop a question and I'll make sure that I get you an answer throughout the show. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope that you have an amazing day. I'll see you guys really, really soon in the next video. Bye-bye.